morning. Thanks for being with us. It's Thursday, September 23rd. I'm Kieran Chetry.
Good morning to you. I'm John Roberts. Thanks so much for being with us. We've got a lot to talk about this morning. Let's get right to it. The GOP unveiling its pledge to America today, telling voters what they would do if they win control of Congress in November. We have a copy of it this morning. Democrats are calling it a pledge to special interests. We'll show you some of the sweeping changes the GOP is planning and let you decide how you'd describe it.
We also have a CNN exclusive this morning. Elizabeth Warren, handpicked by the president to protect you, the American consumer. Well, she's going to be live on our American Morning studios, and she's hitting the ground running, ready to reform the way that banks write mortgages. The plan to uncomplicate the process when Elizabeth Warren joins us live in just 10 minutes.
And rebuilding Haiti 8 months after a devastating earthquake, how much real progress is being made? And is the world doing enough to help? Jason Carroll's one-on-one interview with Haiti's prime minister just ahead.
We have the AM Fix blog up and running. If you'd like to weigh in, join the live conversation, head to CNN.com/AMFix.
Up first this morning, laying out the blueprint. Today, Republican leaders will tell voters how they would govern if they take back Congress in November in a 21-page pledge to America.
Yep, we have a copy of it here at CNN, and it basically promises to unravel, in some cases, President Obama's first 2 years in office. And it starts by saying, quote, an arrogant and out-of-touch government of self-appointed elites makes decisions, issues mandates, and enacts laws without accepting or requesting the input of the many. Now, the Republicans also are pledging to cut taxes as well as federal spending, to repeal President Obama's health care law, and to ban federal funding of abortion. Today marks the six-month anniversary of health care reform becoming law.
Yeah, that means that some big changes are finally kicking in for you, and that could reignite the fight over reform just in time for the midterm elections. Jim Acosta, live for us in Washington this morning, breaking it down. Good morning, Jim.
Good morning, John and Kara. No big parties today for the six-month anniversary of health care reform, but today a slew of new provisions do go into effect. Take, for example, a new ban on insurance companies that discriminate against children with pre-existing conditions. Republicans vow they will take a big axe to all of these changes to health care if they're put in charge.
I would fight to repeal the bill.
It's GOP battle cry for the midterm elections.
The American people will be heard and we'll repeal and replace.
I have pledged as my first act of legislation to put in a repeal Obamacare law.
If Republicans win a majority of seats in Congress, one of the first things they promise to do is repeal President Obama's signature achievement, health care reform.
What's your response to it?
Under a new GOP-controlled House, Texas Congressman Joe Barton would likely become chairman of a key House committee overseeing health care. He says hearings would begin as soon as January to dismantle the law.
If we're given the opportunity to be in the majority, we are going to try to repeal it and then replace
right
it
away
with something that makes sense. Well, the sooner the better.
That threat comes as new portions of the law go into effect this week. Provisions that stop insurers from denying coverage to children with pre-existing conditions or dropping policies for people who get sick. Big expansions of coverage don't come until 2014. Still, recent polls show the law remains unpopular.
I voted against the health care bill because I thought it would be too expensive.
Even some Democrats are running against it. Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius argues the public will come around.
Why is this law so unpopular?
I think it's more confusing than unpopular.
You would grant that it's unpopular right now.
Well, when
it's
you
not
say
as popular as you would like.
That's accurate. I think it's based, though, a lot on people believing that the law contains elements that it doesn't have, death panels.
You're ready to have this debate all over again.
I am indeed.
Hello, hello, hello.
So is the president, who points to parts of the bill that are popular.
If young people don't have health insurance through their employer, that they can stay on their parents' health insurance up to the age of 26.
Parts Congressman Barton wants to keep.
But are there portions of the law that should be kept?
Well, I think coverage of pre-existing conditions, the ability to keep your insurance and not have it revoked unless you, unless you committed fraud.
Other Republicans say scrap the whole thing. Conservative activist Alex Cortez with the group defundit.org says the solution is to starve the law of money.
I mean, one of our only options is defunding. Go after some of the smaller provisions. We will not let Kathleen Sebelius implement and enforce this law.
But tinkering with health care reform will not be easy. Any bill changing the law would likely be vetoed by the president, and Republicans have no chance of picking up enough seats in the midterms to override that veto. But Republicans say just because they may not have the votes doesn't mean they won't try. John and Kieran.
Jim Acosta this morning in Washington. Jim, thanks. And at 6:40 Eastern, we're going to talk with health care economist Paul